So, Brandon, you've been working this last week on setting up your computer again and getting multiplayer running.
Yes, I have.
And actually,
And
that's what we're looking at right now, I believe, on the stream, right? Yeah. So, how is that going?
it's actually going pretty well. I right now what I'm currently handling is I was able to test it with hotkeys on the player, but right now I'm doing it where whenever you walk into a portal, you will then get the it'll cast it over to the player, and it will then send them over into the world that they need to go into. So let's hit test and let's watch it work.
So this is all
Suddenly
running
streaming in.
inside the Unreal Engine 5, and Brandon's got this set up so that we can all play together.
Loaded that in, so it said created session. It also sent the message over to in the client over to the other ones. But if I hop into this portal now, it should send the player over to it. There we go.
There you go.
And then now let's go to this other one because these ones you can see them running around. It all works, but it is sending each individual player and it's able to get the owner aspects of the components of the player, so it knows exactly which one is being what screen is controlling what, which could also mean which computer is controlling what.
Yeah.
So there we go. It's multiplayer's working.
Yeah.
Just gotta add gravity.
We really need a. Okay. To Alicia. Alicia, what have you been up to?
I have been working on the building some more, and I have also been working on rocks, but today for the stream, we're going to work on the buildings. Maybe a little later we can show off the rocks a little bit,
All
but
right, yeah, let's do that. Let's do that in a bit.
this is this building I'm working on right now. It's like a little bit of a smaller one. You can see kind of the scale reference to our characters.
Yeah, it looks good.
And yeah, so I will be modeling this.
So what we're doing is we're designing a city. Let me pull up some concept art so we can talk about that a bit too. I feel like that's always a good thing on the stream. We can show off some of the stuff. And you'll see the city as we've been building it. But these are what Alicia's doing is she's building each building in kind of a modular pieces and blocking them in so we can put them in and get a good layout before we really go into great levels of detail. Before we put like, with this new engine, we have the ability that we can make up stories and we can paint those stories in this world on the corners of buildings, sometimes in cities. I lived in Vancouver for a long time and I used to see like big chunks of the building ripped out, but it was probably from like a truck backing into it. But I used to think like that's where like a vampire and a werewolf had a battle last night, and that's where the head got smashed into the concrete. We can do that level of sculpting and imagination into our world. Oh yeah, this is all the concept from the early days. Nice. This is look, the first Kimmy model. This was the very first Kimmy. We took her and went this direction with her. And now you know her as the Kimmy we see in the stream. Pull up the environment shot, which it should be in here, but it might not. So this is one of our shots for the environment for our moon crater. This too. This is the style we're going towards, and that's why on last week's stream, Alicia showed off, I think, the shader that you had prototyped, mm-hmm. And that's what we're going to be applying to this type of model here. a part of our city built out, like the moon land, the prototyping of the moon. We played the actual first moon land live. And, oh, well, and I'll show you again today. We'll test out the game. But I wanted to show the process of what we were actually using to build our ground, which is we're using 3D scan data right now to test out the nanite processes in the Unreal Engine. And I have a scene here. I can show you. This is my Blender scene. And I'll give you a little taste of what I'm talking about here. So if I load in, let's see, the large rocks, this is actually a 3D scan. Let's give it a sec to load. And we'll load the textures on it. So this is an actual 3D scan of rocks I took outside. And we were able to take it and convert it to geometry, you see here, and use it in the new nanite processes in the game. you'll recognize the piece of ground that we just put in that demo right here. Nope, right here. So that is the same piece of ground that you saw earlier used on our ground here to create the moon's environment, as you can see. So this is our test bed. This is where we're testing all of our assets. And you can see these are different scans that I've done outside. And we're able to place them together in the Unreal Engine with Nanite. And they combine together to create a very stable, nice mesh for us to use. I'll show this off again just like last week. Last week I showed off this section of the demo. So this is our moon land. You know what? I'm going to make it bigger for you. Here you guys go. So this is our Moonland test universe. This is, we got the floating asteroids, really good atmospheric effects, different levels of rocks. As you can see here, this is me testing the quality and frequency of our 3D models over the scan, the surfaces. So, can you tell everyone what you're looking at here?
On the screen?
Yeah.
So, what I have here, let me actually move this on over.
Describe Blueprint.
It's very far away.
Describe what Blueprint is first.
So, Blueprint is like a visual scripting language. So, imagine, like, circuits. Like, you have to have a battery connected to a light, and then connect the positive to the negative of the battery to create a circuit going. That's basically what this is. You're making circuits of logic. So, for example, on this one, this whenever the player walks into this little pink box thingy, it will then send over, turn the light on. It will then send a message to the player that walked into it, and it will run a function called netcheck. And if I go over here, or an event called netcheck, and in netcheck right here, it gets triggered, and then it pauses the player's movement. It looks for a session to join. And if the session, if there is a session, which right now it's doing like a, if the session length is greater than zero, join a session. But if not, it'll say creating session, and it creates a session, and then it sends you on over to there, as well as rips the loading screen off the screen. So it's just kind of sending signals to different things, just like a circuit. And then over here, after it does the net check, it looks for the player controller, and then it runs the loading screen event, which then creates the loading screen on there. And I think I just found the issue of why it was misbehaving earlier. So let's do that.
If you guys don't know, game development is 100% bug fixing. And again, if you're just tuning in now, this is Moonland, and we're building an open-world social multiplayer game that is going to be available on PC, but eventually we're hoping console. Maybe just some of our mini games will be available on console, but you'll see them shortly. And we're going to, let's see. A complete, already, like, what, 50 or 40 billion different combination character creator done. Like, so your guys are going to have access to that as soon as the website is up as well. And we're going to have you guys building your characters. And in the future, we're actually going to be able to mint your characters as NFTs. We're going to release an NFT pack of a crap load of minted or of different character combinations, and that's going to give you guys entries into a chance to play our early access, which is going to be really exciting to share with you. Let's hold that off till episode 12, 13, which is today's episode 9 of the Top Secret Development Stream.